Welcome to the Land of Illusion Haunted Scream Park.
Wow, this is amazing.
Yeah, so what all can we do, scary dude?
You can go through any of 6 haunted attractions. Take a look around. You'll see the entrance to each nearby. And in between haunts, grab a soda or adult beverage in the bar, order a snack, and warm up by the fire pit.
We can totally make a night of this.
Yeah, this is great. Let's get started.
Land of Illusion is more than you think. Make a night of it. Get your mobile tickets now at landofillusion.com.
Hey, we have a special episode today. You know how every year we talk about all of the best haunts in the country and we keep coming back to Land of Illusion?
Yes.
This great haunt park, which is like almost...
A scream park, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yes.
Haunted Scream Park, yep. Yeah.
That's the voice of Brad Wymore. He is the marketing manager for Land of Illusion. And he's here to tell us about all the new exciting stuff that's coming this year. I sound like an excited child because I am an excited child.
We love
child.
Haunt season.
As do I. Very excited to be here. Very excited to talk about the 2017 season at Land of Illusion. We've got a ton of exciting stuff going on. We've got a few new features on the Haunted Trail. It's called...
That thing is so good.
It's the longest haunted trail in the Midwest, 1.25 miles, and we've got a new feature called the Hatch.
Ooh, the Hatch. Do we go into the Hatch?
So, you know,
in
classic haunted scream park form, I'm not going to give away too much.
No spoilers.
But, yeah, no spoilers. But I will tell you this, it's kind of a White Walkers meets Alien experience.
I think
we're all caught up. On
I think
Game
that
of
was the way to our heart. That.
Yeah,
right there.
Those are two big mainstays to mention in the Alien franchise and Game of Thrones franchise. Those are big to slam together right there.
I think we've talked about it for the last couple of years, but the Haunted Trail is where our Andy, who's not here today, another one of our hosts, falls down 85 times during it because he's so terrified.
Yeah.
And I'm usually behind him or our friend Mikey B, and we have to pick him up and carry him through the damn thing because he's so terrified.
His legs give
and
out.
And it's like 1.25 miles long. I mean, that's a long time to be carrying Andy. He's tiny, but Jesus.
And we always save it for the end of the night because it's like a greatest hits of all the other ones for us.
But anyway, I just wanted to say that.
For people who haven't heard our previous coverage of Land of Illusion, Brad, can you explain what it is?
Absolutely. So we are, as we've referred to it, as a haunted scream park. We're not just a singular haunted house. When you come to Land of Illusion, it is hours of entertainment. We have 4 haunts, plus the Haunted Trail. The haunts are Temple of Terror, Dr. Psycho's, Killer Clowns, for all those people that love the clowns.
That ruined me last year.
And then the Bayou Shanty.
That's my favorite.
Yeah, that's our classic. And that here's a little tidbit for 2018. That actually is going to get a total revamp for 2018.
Really?
So this is the last season for Bayou Shanty, as everyone knows it.
Are they keeping the horrible smells?
The smell
part?
Yes,
absolutely.
Can't get rid of that.
Yeah, no, that's coming forward to 2018 for sure.
What about the guy last year that threatened to bleach my anus in that haunt? And I was like, no, thank you. And then I ran into the dude with the bleach jug.
He's actually now the senior VP of marketing.
I figured he should be. I mean, he asked nicely.
Yeah, well, and that's why he got the promotion. He's very polite. So,
I forgot all about that until you said bye. And I was like, oh, yeah.
So we've got the four haunts, and obviously, as you pointed out, a cast of characters throughout all of them. The Haunted Trail, which we referenced earlier, and the new Hatch experience. And then, of course, my favorite, the Zombie Sniper Patrol.
Oh, yeah.
That's just, I refer to it as a completely unique experience in the Midwest. I've done my research, and there's no other place out there. And basically, what you do is you load into an Army-style truck and get as many paintballs as you want to purchase and fire away on live zombies, so it's you against the apocalypse.
So cathartic.
Yes, exactly. I honestly feel like we should be charging much more than we are because it is additional to the park.
So worth it.
But it's like a therapy session.
Yeah.
You could go see a really high-end psychologist for $1, $175 an hour, or just come and blast zombies for $15. So.
And then get chased by those really great stunt drive. Oh, never mind.
Yeah, no spoilers. But there's some pretty heavy-duty stuff for the climax
of
that one. That's great.
Deal.
Yes.
In addition to all these great haunts, when you go, you guys also do like concerts on a stage. I mean, this, you have to visualize this park.
It's
you
a
go
whole
into
night.
It like a Disney park. Like it has the gates.
Yep.
You go through, there's a hub with this bonfire, and then these spokes of the hub are the haunts, and then you have a stage where a lot of the time they're showing like music videos, and so it's just a party atmosphere in between the haunts, which I really love.
And a bar.
Absolutely. So and thank you for the last piece. So yeah, we've got the Voodoo Lounge and the Dragon's Pub, which can round out your evening. And as you pointed out, that kind of frames in the main area as you walk in. And this year on the Stage of Rage, which we picked up a sponsor for that, so I'll mention them. Buckeye Harley out of Dayton is the official sponsor for the Stage of Rage this year, and we've got a full concert series. So opening weekend, September 1st, is opening night. We're gonna have a DJ on the Stage of Rage, and then September 2nd, we've got the Rozzy Family Fireworks.
Oh wow!
So Rozzy's coming out. They're actually going to kind of use us as their warm up for the EBN fireworks.
Oh, cool.
That Labor Day weekend. So they're going to come out big display on Saturday night. Very excited for that. And that kind of kicks off our whole season of events. So on Fridays, we're going to do classic horror movies.
Really?
Yep. Every Friday, we're going to run classic horror movies on the big screen at Stage of Rage. And then Saturdays is when we do our actual live concert event. So the highlights for that, I think all the listeners will recognize this name from the 90s. GWAR is going to be at Land of Illusion.
Shit, really?
Yes, we have GWAR.
No.
And all their blood spitting glory. So yeah, GWAR is going to be there September 16th. Price of admission includes the ticket.
That's awesome.
$36.99 to get in the park. Don't have to pay any extra. You get GWAR on top of that. So all the haunts that we've been talking about, plus GWAR. What more can you ask for?
Yeah. It's a fantastic deal.
And then the very next weekend, September 23rd, we've got Mushroom Head out of Cleveland. Mm-hmm. They're like a GWAR light. You know, they're still crazy.
They just played Warhound Weekend.
Yes, that's exactly right. So Mushroom Head's going to be there September 23rd. September 30th, we've got Thunderstruck. AC/DC cover band.
You gotta love that.
October 7th, we've got a bike night and band 90 Proof Twang. And if you're a Land of Illusion enthusiast, you've actually seen them a couple of times. They've been on the Stage of Rage in the years past.
I like the name.
Yeah, good name, good band, high energy. Twang. Yeah. And then on October 27th, we've got Cal Scrubby, who is a local Cincinnati guy, lives out in LA now. It's kind of a YouTube hip hop star.
Oh,
so cool. All the millennials will love that.
The children.
I'll be there just kind of bobbing my head, looking awkward. But everybody else is going to be loving Cal Scrubby. And then for all the details and everything around our content series, just go to landofillusion.com and you can learn more.
Yeah. This is like if a horror fan dies and goes to heaven. It's Land of Illusion, I think.
I think my dog's really excited about it, and she's humping my leg right now. Millie, sweetheart,
the energy in the room.
You can't go. They don't let dogs in.
You can't.
They don't.
Yeah, unfortunately not.
Since you have Harley as a sponsor, do I sense that there will one day be a bike haunt?
Ooh. Oh, like a skeleton riding I think so.
Up Let's and just, down the trail.
Yeah, I think there's got to be something. Yeah, I know we're looking at doing a bike night next year, but right now, there's no exact plans for it, but I like it. Maybe this could be the impetus behind it right here.
That could be really cool. So I think some of our fondest Halloween memories have been forming at Land of Illusion. So if you're listening to this, by the way, I want to go back to that Rozzy Fireworks thing.
Mm-hmm.
If you are not from the tri-state area of Ohio,
they're world famous.
You do probably know the name Rozzy Brothers, but if you don't, the reason that's a special thing is if you go to any major fireworks show, chances are the Rozzy's designed it or provided the material. So like it's something special. So
they've been blowing stuff up for decades. So they're incredibly good at it.
So it's amazing stuff.
So I have a question. This is a question that occurs to me every year, and I don't know if you can answer this, but I'm gonna ask because we do a lot of haunts in the season, as it were, because we're fans and we enjoy it. But there's a thing I worry about called fog machine lung. Is that a worry? Does anybody ever ask, like, are the people that work there, anybody concerned about inhaling all of that?
I think we have a special rider on our employee healthcare plan where they have to check a box that they cannot come back against us for a fog machine lung.
And it's like, how much, you know, do you spend on lozenges for your people that work there for all the screaming and yelling?
I was looking at the budget the other day. I think it's about 5% of total spend.
It would have to be.
It's a good number. It's
it
big.
It would have to be.
It's a whole lot of lozenges.
Yeah, exactly. We should actually reach out to Ricola and see if they would like to, or Ricola, however you want to pronounce it.
Yes. Yeah. Because that's the thing I worry about every year. I'm like, how are you guys doing? Are you hydrating? I worry about the workers, your fog machine lung, and your lozenges. Are you getting taken care of in those ways?
And I also got to say that these workers, I think one of the reasons we joke about that so much, especially when we talk about Land of Illusion, is they are so into it.
The ones at Land of, you guys, I think, do a more rigorous hiring practice, maybe.
I will share a story that Brett Oakley, who's the mastermind behind Land of Illusion, this is, by the way, this is a piece that I probably should have brought up. It is our 20th season.
Oh, wow.
So 20 years of fears.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Very proud of that. Brett thought this up 20 years ago and has been building steadily every single year. We've got some, like I said, the hatch this year and some other fun stuff. But the story I wanted to share is that on the Haunted Trail, we have, I would say, a dozen or so of the actors have been doing it for 10 plus years.
Oh, wow.
And that's pretty impressive.
That says something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it is. It's a family. It's a crazy family.
Yeah, it would have
But it is a family. everybody's super passionate about it. I mean, we start getting direct messages through our Facebook page from people who have done the acting piece, in June.
Really?
Like, are we still on for this year? You know, all this stuff. So, it's an intense and passionate bunch, which is great. I think that actually puts us apart from some of the other haunts.
No, you can definitely tell. Like, it's extremely professional, and they're trying to give you the best experience possible and not just hustle you through the line. Although, hey, when it's busy, let's get it moving here.
True. There's definitely that, and obviously the Fast Pass will help mitigate some of those concerns.
Yes,
I love the Fast Pass. That's an easy add-on to general admission. You can get through all the haunts that much faster and get to the Voodoo Lounge and have some beers and hang out. We've got a large, you referenced earlier the center area. We actually have this main fire pit that we've built this year, propane fire pit, covered pagoda and all this stuff. So a little hangout area for all those millennials that are there to see Cal Scrubby.
They're there for Cal Scrubby. They're there to flirt with each other.
That's right.
While
you're looking at your phone, not talking to each other.
Well, yeah, that too.
There'll be 1,000 YouTube videos of the performance.
Exactly. The most well-documented concert ever.
So
it's true.
There was also talk of a costume contest that's coming up.
Yes. So, of course, Game of Thrones is the center of the universe.
Did you see it Sunday? Did you see
it? I did not.
It's a good
one. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, I heard it was more conversational than previous episodes.
More chess piece moving around sort of thing than dragons and such. But
more dialogue.
It was good.
Sets up a lot of good stuff.
Nice.
Good. I liked it.
Love that show. So we are going to have a Game of Thrones costume contest on October 13th, Friday the 13th.
Oh, that's right.
The easy play would have been Jason, but what? Let's be modern. Yeah. Let's be current. So we're going to welcome everybody out to the park, do a full-blown costume contest for Game of Thrones, and of course there'll be prizes, and hope everybody comes out.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think about who I would go as, but I don't know.
Yeah.
It's a tough one. Who's the most terrifying, Cersei?
Yeah. Yeah, I think you'll see a lot of hounds.
Oh, yeah.
That'd be a great one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There was the guy with the Halloween party last year who's dressed like the Septa, like the nun lady.
Oh, and he had a blow-up doll with him.
Oh.
That was supposed to be Cersei.
Oh, that's a nice
And he had a bell, and he was like, shame, shame, but the blow-up doll was naked. And it was there. You get it. You guys.
Right.
We get it.
No worries.
Okay, thank you. That was a good one. That guy should do that.
I would go as a White Walker, but I might be too tall for that. I don't know.
A lot of makeup.
Yeah, a lot of makeup. And next thing I know, I've been like pulled into the hatch part of the experience, and that wouldn't work.
They'd expect you to perform.
Yeah, that's right. Exactly.
All you got to do is go get an IKEA rug, apparently.
Yeah,
that's
did
where
you see that article?
The costumer is said that most of these dudes are wearing IKEA rugs.
Oh, that's great. No, I didn't see that. That's
so
awesome.
So the local IKEA is going to be out of rugs if you don't hurry.
That's right. Get there now. IKEA. October 13th is coming soon.
That's really
cool. If you don't have a reason to go to Land of Illusion already from all of this, I mean, just going for the haunts is enough.
Yeah.
But all this extra stuff.
It's worth the drive. Like, just for me, it's a pretty decent drive, but I would drive further. It is worth the drive. It's out Middletown,
yeah.
Ohio.
Yep, Middletown, Ohio. Right off the Franklin exit.
Yeah, and it's, yeah.
Come get a hotel room and stay overnight. If you're from out of town,
yeah.
Do it up. Come when they open, stay till they close. Do it up. You're going to love it.
Yeah.
Guaranteed.
So fun.
That you
will. You're so tired. It's the end of the night because you've been screaming and running and picking your friend Andy up.
Yeah.
Nice. Dodging teenagers that run at you because they're terrified. That happened to me last year. What else?
I totally agree. I think it is. It's as we promote it, we call it 6 hours. You know, I mean, it's every bit of 6 hours.
Oh,
so
yeah.
if you want, I highly recommend what you're saying. That is, you know, go to landofillusion.com. We've got a plan your visit section with all the links to local hotels. You can just book right from there. No problem. And make a night of it. Get a big group going and don't have to worry about driving anywhere. There's Uber, there's Lyft out there, so you can go from the hotel.
All the way out there?
Well, from the hotel.
No, I'm just kidding.
No, well, that would be a slightly pricey from Cincinnati to Middletown. Yeah.
So, absolutely worth it. Now, something I wanted, you guys do season pass too, which is something we've always noticed.
We do. Cool. So, right now, we're selling our season pass because of the 20-year celebration. We've got a code that you can use, PASS17, gets you $20 off our $120 pass, which pays for itself after 3 visits. So, definitely, you know, doing the math on that, it makes sense. So, go use the code PASS17 and you'll get the season pass for $99.99.
So worth it. Every time we leave this haunt, we immediately are like, God, I wish we could come back tomorrow.
And then I'm just like, I need to go to bed. I'm so tired from screaming, running, picking my friend Andy up.
You end up at the Waffle House in the middle of nowhere
after
talking about it.
Yes, that's true.
Such
that's
a good experience.
True.
But get to know Brad a little more. What's your favorite horror movie?
Yeah.
So I knew we were going to talk about this, so I did some soul searching, and it's going to be a boring answer, but it in my mind is
Don't apologize. The
classic theater of the mind scary movie, and that's The Shining.
Oh, yeah. That's a great answer.
And I think probably because it's one that got in early into my psyche. You know, I watched it as a kid, and those two twins holding hands at the end of the hallway, like... twins and hallways are forever ruined for me. I mean, it's just ridiculous how scary that movie is to me. So I think that's my go-to. That's my favorite.
Now, are you a fan of the book?
No, I never read the book. So, I mean, okay. I'm sure I would be. I just not read it.
Well, it's funny. A lot of people are split book versus movie on that one.
Oh, okay.
Because Kubrick took so many licenses with it. We have a friend who is diehard, like, it's not faithful to the book. And he's all, I've read it. I've seen the movie. I think they're both fantastic.
Yeah.
But yeah, that movie's got to be one of the greatest films.
I've never read that book.
Yeah, so good. At least there's two of us at the table here. It's good.
But if you have you been to the Overlook Lodge yet?
Yes.
Yeah. Isn't that great? Yeah.
Crazy. Yeah. I mean, especially given my already pretty intense fear of that that movie. Yeah, it was really entertaining.
Was
really
it hard to walk in?
A little bit. Like, yeah. I was definitely like, should I cross over this threshold? Like, is this going to be too much for me?
It's a nuanced, feeling about the movie, but I think it's still kind of a spooky little place.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You've heard us talk about that. In case you haven't, it's the Shining themed bar here in Cincinnati.
Yep.
Who we've had the owner on. And we do live shows there.
Oh,
but
cool.
It's really fun. We're doing one. I don't know. We've said this already publicly, but on the 30th of August, we're going to be there with John Dugan from Texas Chainsaw Massacre. We're doing a Q&A and then a screening.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm still getting clearance to do that over Facebook Live so we can at least show you the Q&A.
Clearance.
From permission.
From the people.
But so thanks again, Brad Wymore, marketing manager at Land of Illusion. I think the best haunt in the country. I still haven't been to them all, but I you'd be hard pressed to beat it.
It's my favorite for sure. That I've been to. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's my favorite.
Needless to say, I'm going to completely agree with you.
Yes.
And of course, thank you both. I really appreciate this. It's been a great first podcast for me.
So yeah.
Had a great time. Obviously, we'll come back whenever you need me.
We'll happily have you back whenever. All right. Great.
Thanks
again.
Thanks.
If he should go to bed when his old buddy Leatherface
of Long